Hello and welcome to another Demon 212 WiiWare review. Today I'm going to be taking a look at Max and the Magic Marker, which we've never played before. It's basically a puzzle or platformer type thing, and just to put anyone's mind at ease, if they're wondering about information about the game but don't want it to be spoiled because it's just full of puzzles and that and they don't want us to spoil anything, it's just going to be the first couple of levels because I don't want to spoil anything because there's not much in the game overall anyway. But that doesn't mean it's not a bad, good game, it's brilliant. So, at the start, you've got the profiles, well, there's three of them. You've got the extras, which basically the extras tracks your progress, sees how well you're doing. But then from there, you've got the start game, basically. As I see it, there's not much on the game, so I'm not going to show much. There's basically 15 levels and 3 worlds, and that's just a preview of the worlds, but I want to file with only the first 2 levels unlocked, so that way I definitely can't show anything else off. But, basically though, after all the loading and stuff like that, you start like this. You have to push A and B, and then it goes into one of the best looking games I've seen on the Wii, period. So, from there, you've then got a few controls you have to learn. Z jumps, and you can hang onto the edges of things and climb yourself up and stuff like that. There is a slight problem with these controls, the Z and the up and that, because basically it doesn't always work sometimes, so sometimes you'll find yourself running off the edge of a platform instead of jumping, and sometimes you just won't grab onto the end of a ledge, like for example that there. But for the most part it works, and it's not the type of thing that's really gonna, well, at least I hope it's not the type of thing that's gonna screw you over. It hasn't screwed me over majorly, but I'm not you, so who knows. So anyway, from there, you've then got the pen and the marker, whatever you want to call it. It's obviously a magic marker, but basically, you have to collect ink, which is what they are. And from there, you can draw pretty much anything that your imagination can set your, well, sights to. So draw boxes, you can push boxes and stuff. You can draw boxes to smash onto enemies' heads and that, which is pretty cool. I'll show that off later on. In this bit, pretty much the first puzzle in the game, you have to draw a bridge, and you just basically use the ink to draw stuff. After you go past the checkpoint though, as you might have noticed, all your ink gets taken by the monsters, so you have to collect it again. And if you've built something, then you can actually delete it to get the ink back, or if you build something and it, for example, falls into the water, you get the ink back, or at least, there we go, I was just about to say you're supposed to, but it did indeed come back, it just took a while. And that's basically how the marker works, just with a pointer and that. It works really well. It's the type of thing that, if you've ever played Nick's Quest, I suppose probably the best way to mention it, then you'll notice it plays very familiar to that, and how you drag things and that. But anyway, that's the marker. So from there as well, the only other control, to be fair, I haven't mentioned, is pretty much that you can push things with a C button. So this is basically what I was saying though about dropping things on enemies' heads. There's an enemy there and you've got to drop it from a great height and make sure you aim it up properly, so I'll just hold it there and I'll wait until it's absolutely going to get him. But as you might notice there, he's got a hard hat on, so I have to wait until he gets the hard hat off, and there we go, bam, dead. So that's basically how you kill the enemies. It's really cool, it works well, and I think it's quite funny as well, but then again I've always thought dropping things on enemies' heads were quite funny. So there we go then, that's pretty much killing the enemies. Musically, the game is, well, it's one of those that it suits the game well, but I think it is a little basic in places, but it still is decent enough and it's pleasant and cheery and that, so I'm going to shut up for a bit and let you have a little listen now. So there we go then, that was a little bit of the music, and this is the other thing I need to mention. You saw at the start when I was in this mode, basically you can go back into it again and you can draw things outside of the time zone, well, timeline or whatever you want to call it. So it does come in useful in places and you'll have to basically figure out when to use it and why you use it and that, but it is there, you just push A and B at any time. There's then pretty much the only other things I've got left to mention are basically the length of the game. As I say, 15 levels over 3 worlds. It's not the longest game, and the developers are basically saying it takes about 4 hours if you're a decent gamer. Anything, if you like better than that, then you'll do it shorter. And they can beat the game themselves, which you'd expect this because it's their game, but they can beat it in 57 minutes. There are some things you can do, though, to actually lengthen the lifespan. For one, there's 63 secrets in the game. For another, there's 700 and odd, I can't remember exactly how many, but there's 700 and odd sections with these things, like these little light bulb type things. So there's 700 and odd of them to collect. There's then also the speedruns, which basically you get a speedrun by beating the game and, well, by beating the levels in a certain time. It tells you when you beat a level, just what you have to beat it in to get the speedrun. So there are a few things there that actually give you a bit more gameplay. But then, that's pretty much everything I've got left to mention. The only other thing I can do is show you this, which is basically the end of a level, so that way you can see what you have to be aiming for. And the, obviously, you've seen sections with the seesaw and that, but then there's sections like this with the trampoline that you have to figure out. And, well, that is literally it. Other than, if you want to try the game, for some unknown reason, Nintendo haven't released a demo on the WiiWare service, but they've instead released a demo on the PC version. Like, the developers of the game have released a demo on the PC. It doesn't work on all browsers, but it definitely works on Firefox. I've tried it out, and it works. And it's what made me actually want the game. So just go to their official site to try the demo out, and to see if you think it's worth spending 1,000 points on. So there we go then, that's been the review. I hope you've enjoyed it, or at least found it helpful. You might have noticed I didn't score the game. Well, that's because it's a matter of personal opinion, and yours may very well differ from my own. I'm just here to show you a bit about the game. If you like it or not, well, that's up to you. If you don't like it, or you do like it, feel free to comment. Also, if I haven't answered any of your questions that you may have had, I might have forgot something, or it might just be something obscure. Again, feel free to comment, ask, always willing to help out. Otherwise, if you don't like commenting on YouTube, head over to www.vc-forums.com, where you can chat with me and a bunch of other lads who love the VC, the WiiWare, and hell, even a lot of other systems. We cater to pretty much everything. You can just go there, have a chat about a game, ask about some games, etc. So until next time, this has been Demon212, signing off.